Let's go to the next nakshatra, Krittika nakshatra, which is, we all know, it is known as Cutter, the star of fire, and the Hindi name is the Kullar tree, or we call it Udambra, and there is a botanical name as well. Shakti behind is Dahana Shakti, the power to burn or to cut away the negativity. We all know Krittika is known for the fire rituals, the sharp one, the cutter one, body part, hips, head, loins. What loins are? It is basically the area behind your spine. So the general ailments, insomnia, high blood pressure, bleeding of nose, brain fever. Again, the head part comes into effect. See how it is related. Lack of mental peace. So, beautiful mythology. Because what we can learn from the mythology, we cannot learn from anywhere else. We all know, in order to kill Hiranyakashipu, Lord Vishnu took the avatar of that as Narsimha. When he tore open the stomach of the demon with his claws, the demon's stomach was having a poison called Kaluta poison. And I was fascinated when I was doing the research and got this slide. Due to this poison, Lord Narsimha's nails were suffering from the great pain and heat, again associated with the Krittika fire. So it is said that Mata Lakshmi could not see the suffering and pluck the some fruits of the Udambra tree, Gullar tree, which was nearby at that time. So Lord Narsimha put his nails into the deep pulp of the fruit that cooled off his pain. So the Lord was so pleased and blessed the Udambra tree and said it would be as powerful as earth, as Kalpa Vriksha in heaven.
Wow.
And whoever will worship Udambra tree will get his desire fulfilled. So thus this tree become the wish fulfilling tree by the Vishnu's grace. And here's the source for the same. So how beautiful that is, Babaji. See how the heat part is coming into effect. Maybe a lot of people knew, but I did not knew. That when he did this leela, jab unhone ye leela rachi, there was a Kaluta poison who affected Lord Narsimha himself. So how the tree or the nakshatra is playing out big time in this?
Yeah, in fact, regarding this, 2 years back, I had made a video exactly this time for Pitrupaksha.
Okay.
Regarding this, so I would like to take the opportunity to say this here because I was waiting when this slide will come.
Okay.
Yeah, so in the Srimad Bhagavatam, this pastime is there in the 7th canto. Alright.
Okay.
So in that, it is said that when Narsingdev ripped apart the stomach of Hiranyakashipu,
yes,
like Lord Vishnu has a lot of weapons, you know, he has this, his gada is there, you know, and then his chakra is there, and then he has sarang, that dhanush, okay, the bow and all. So these his weapons started protesting.
Okay.
They said that, what an injustice this is. We feel as if we will die. Why? Because this time when you are killing a demon, you are not going to use us.
Right.
I mean, right. We are of no use to you. What is the use of our existence? Better let us go and die. You know, it's like we are useless totally.
Wow.
Our value is only when we are connected to you. Otherwise, we are useless totally. So then Narsimha said that, hey, hold on. Don't go and jump into the river. Don't commit suicide. What you do, Lord Brahma has blessed him that he will not die with any weapon. So I have to make sure that Lord Brahma's word is not broken, because then nobody will respect him later.
Exactly.
So Lord Narsimha said, okay, so I have a plan for you. See,
okay.
I will rip him through my nails, but all of you, chakra and gada and all this, you know, arrows, all the divine weapons, all the divyastras, you come and hide behind my nails.
Okay. Wow.
When I hit him, then you start your job.
Wow.
I will start the cutting, you start the surgery.
Wow.
And then later on, what happened? When his intestines were ripped apart, nursing right. did not stop.
Okay.
Nursing Dev was taking out his intestines and he was very meticulously checking his intestines. Yeah. Can you believe it?
Yeah.
Somebody yeah. asked that, why in the universe is he checking his intestines?
Intestines, yeah.
Then the answer was given that Nursing Dev was astonished that from such a sinful, dreaded demon, like Hiranyakashipu, such a great soul like Prahlad came. How? How is it possible? So Narasimha was going on checking in his intestines that is there any other great soul waiting to take birth in his intestines?
Wow.
Prahlad. We can have so many Prahlads then.
Wow. And then, I never knew about this.
Yeah, and everybody was like astonished and they were thinking that, oh my God, what is going on here? And then Narasimha, after he saw that there are nothing left, and then he just ripped his body apart. And then it is said that he was so angry. Narasimha was so angry. His anger was about to destroy the entire universe. It was like, he was so angry.
Yeah.
Then Lord Brahma requested the Goddess Lakshmi that, Madam, you are his beloved wife.
Please cool him down.
Please go and cool him down. You know, it is only you who can do, you know. And then Lakshmi Devi was like, you know, I know he's my husband, but I have never seen him in this form. I can't go near him, you know. Yeah. And then Brahmaji was thinking, I will go, but he was also fearing, you know, what nursing they will do. And then they approached Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva said, no, I can't go. I'm very fearful. I don't know what has happened to him today.
Right.
And then Brahmaji said that he is angry because this demon has tortured Prahlad.
Yes.
And therefore, Prahlad is the only one who can go and,
calm him down.
Yeah. And then Brahmaji, all of the devatas, they told Prahlad that, my dear Prahlad, you go there. Okay. Mm. And then when they told this to Prahlad, then Prahlad did not say, anyways, you know, you big people, you know, you can't do anything. You know, it's me after all. You see, I am the showstopper now. You know, I will go and... In Bollywood, those days, there was a song, you know, I'm the boss, do you remember?
Yeah.
I'm the best. So later on, he speaks divine prayers in the Bhagavatam. He says that which even people like Lakshmi and Brahma and Shiva cannot do, how can I do that? It is not possible. But I will still try. And then when he went, then Narasimha Dev gave him a special blessing. That, and this is related to Pitru Paksha, very much related.
Okay.
Narasimhadev gave him a blessing that because you are such a great soul, you are born in this dynasty. So, 21 generations above you and 21 generations below, I will deliver, I will liberate all of them.
Wow.
Just imagine.
Wow.
So, in Pitru Paksha is what basically, like, it is like paying reverence and respects. Okay.
Yeah.
If we read this story if you read this story from the seventh canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, and most importantly, if we do spiritual activities, that's what Prahlad did, right?
Yes.
He is the example of a Smara. He always used to think about Lord Vishnu. All right.
Yeah.
He is the example for Smaranam. So if we do that, then if we behave like him, then and we do spiritual activities and one specific mantra for Lord Narasimhadev, Om Namo Bhagavate Narasimhaya. If we do this, and not with some selfish motive that, you know, deliver my ancestors or my descendants, not like that. It is with a prayer that wherever they are, my ancestors or my descendants, wherever they will come after me, please give them an opportunity to practice spiritual life, which means give them the association of spiritually like-minded people.
Right.
Because at the end, when Narsingdev is about to depart, he says to Prahlad, ask one benediction. Kya chahiye tereko bol?
So again, the bhav matters.
Yeah, and then Lord Narsingdev asked, and Prahlad said, no, I don't need anything. Narsingdev was like, no, you have to ask something. No, kuch to bolna padega. Then Prahlad Maharaj said a very interesting thing. He said that, put me in the company of my guru, Narad Muni.
Mm.
He did not say, put me in your company. He did not say, put me in your company. I will always stay behind you, right, left to you. No, he could have done that. But he said, no. If I stay with you, what will happen? Familiarity breeds contempt. So I will think you are also just another person.
Right.
But if I stay with my guru, Narad Muni, he will always be reminding me of who you are actually. Yes. So that is why it is better for degraded people like me to stay in company of Narad Muni. So please bless me that I will always eternally be a servant of my guru, Narad Muni. Because when he was in Kayathu, his mother's womb,
right,
Narad Muni came and spoke, you know, the divine knowledge. And that is how he became Prahlad actually.
Yes.
So, Prabhupada is there, and really, if you read this story and you do spiritual practices and you chant this mantra and you pray to Narsingdev,
yes,
just like you blessed Prahlad, please bless me also.
Yes. That
my ancestors, wherever they are, they will also get a chance to practice spirituality.
You see, and so by, many. Yeah.
And by that, so, their ancestors will be delivered. It's like everybody gets delivered like that.
Right. So many simple remedies are there in the mythology, right, Baba Didi?
Yes, yes. Everything is there, in fact.
Do we really follow it? That's the point.
I mean, why do we need to follow? We just need some remedies for our horoscope, right?
We are good.
We'll go to Banaras and we'll do something there.
Okay. This is again very fascinating. The fourth Veda, the Atharved, regards this tree as the one acquires prosperity and establish dominance over the rivals of the person who has tree planted in their home. So remedy, right here. So now, if, for example, what I mean by that, or what we mean by that, if you are having a tough competition in your business, here's the remedy, right here. But now some of the subscribers or the viewers are going to say, what if my rival also sees this presentation and do the same thing? But again, the law of karma, the luck, the fate, the destiny, that is number one. But this is the ultimate remedy mentioned in the scriptures. Prosperity. Establish the dominance over the rival, the enemy. So those who are going through a very tough situation in their separation, this and that, here's the biggest remedy out there in the scriptures. And again, it is not me who's saying it. The scriptures, they are saying it. And also in the Atharved, it is referred by which we give the Ahuti in the Yajna, again, the fire thing, which is associated with the Krittika Nakshatra, is made from the wood of the Gullar, the Odumbra tree. See the importance of that.
I want to ask you a question. Can you go to that slide where the photo was there of the tree?
Yes.
This is like the round
one. Like a figs. Figs.
Oh, like fruit, figs. Right?
Fruit. But, this is there. The real picture has figs in a red shape, like a heated, like a heat color.
Ah, okay.
This is like a kacha figs on the trees.
Okay.
So here are some Krittika traits, along with the Gulla traits, the Odumba traits, and the remedies. I will not go through each of them, but Krittika traits, we all know they are very well known people. Nurturing power to digest, in order to digest the food in our belly, in our gut, in our stomach, we need the fire. Again, the Krittika has to play a very big role. Fire welds and it melts. It has both sides. Aag lagayegi bhi aur aag bujhayegi bhi. So vibrant, energetic, leadership qualities, cooking fires, courage. These are all Krittika traits. Gullar traits, fast growing tree, just like the fire. It is fast growing. Jab aag lagti hai, toh it's very fast growing. The dull reddish, dark crimson fruit, again the color of the fire coming in the gullar tree, matches absolutely with the Krittika trait. Widespread, just like the fire. The gond of the bark, the sap, which is said in the English, it's considered poisonous. So it has the same quality. Fire welds and melts. So both good and the bad aspects. Again, the production of the red blood cells. Red blood cells. Again, matching with the Krittika traits. And here are the remedies. So if one is suffering through what we have learned in the ailments, raw figs are used in the detoxification. Again, the purifying qualities by the fire. Inflammation, the burning sensation, the bark of the tree is very useful. Rig Veda and the Athar Veda mentions as a tree, it removes the impurities from the blood. That is the whole Shakti behind the Krittika Nakshatra. So these are some of the remedies. I have the big list of the other remedies which I have not mentioned here. So as I am being invited by one of the biggest disciple of Lord Krishna, so I have to talk about Lord Krishna here. And I have to talk about the tree which is associated, one of the trees, or the famous or the biggest or the associated with the Lord Krishna is the Pushya, which is also known as the people, Ashwatha, the Bodhi tree of enlightenment. And it is also known as Pushti, to strengthen, to fortify. And the Shakti behind that, as we all know, that the Pushya Nakshatra is Brahma Varchasa Shakti.